Hugo Pratt is considered one of the most influential authors in the comic book world. Together with Will Ensier, an author we will look at in the future, he invented the graphic novel. He was a complete author. He both wrote a story and drew it. In this video, we'll look at his red thread. All his body of works is connected by a narrative thread in the themes he explores. The first thing that must be said is that drawings, the page, and its submissions into frames become narrative in a comic book. So we'll look at that side as well. The first thing that connects all his work is the idea of freedom. What does that mean? Pratt, through his characters and choice of setting, express a will to not be bound by society's rules, and not to be closed in a box with a single definition, preferring to immerse his characters in a deep, infinite natural setting, like the sea or the desert, which he preferred drawing. The freedom to explore those colossal settings just in search of adventure and experience by his characters is a pivotal part of his stories. The ever-present nature, like forests and shores, give the reader the sensation of a call to be free by human society, but not its relationships. In fact, he introduces large rectangular frames in all his stories, which was done before in comic books, but not as a narrative tool. These frames, which he uses to communicate spatial freedom, the immensity of nature we were talking about, give a distinct feeling of poetry. They are also integral part of the stories, both rhythmically and to communicate action and its pose to the reader. In the story Wheeling, the protagonist is running in the middle of the night in a forest during the American War of Independence. The action is frenetic, yet the nature is free and wild, almost ignoring men and their conflict. Which brings us to another aspect that links all Pratt works: military conflict. As a background of all his stories, Pratt uses military conflict, wars, revolution, or power struggles. All the stories of Corto Maltese, his most famous character, are set before, during, or after World War I, and the conflicts that spewed all over the world as a result. Another example is The Scorpion of the Desert, set in the middle of the Second World War. This type of contest gives Pratt the chance to explore nature, as we mentioned, but also the relationship between the characters and how they react to history happening in front of their eyes. Almost all of his characters are not enlisted soldiers, but mercenaries, pirates, adventurers, deserters, or simply men looking for something in the middle of conflict. Pratt clearly likes to take side in his stories, narrating the tale of people who didn't care for the conflict or were on the losing side, because, as he said in an interview, history was written by winners. But if we look at it by the losing side, we find beautiful stories that deserve to be told. Intrinsically, conflict and nature entwine in his stories, in how one affect the other, like Anna nella giungla, Anna in jungle, set during 1913, in the middle of the colonial era, where the military outposts and steamboats seem out of place on the African shores and jungle, creating a conflict between two disappearing worlds, the untouched nature and the pre-Great War world. The romantic aspect of history, linked with a subtle irony, also connects all Pratt's work. His dialogue and the representation of the stories are permeated by a literary romantic filter. the sense of infinity linked to nature in the frames we mentioned before, like the walk of Rasputin on the shore after killing Cranio in the Ballad of the Salted Sea, or the goodbye between Banshee and Corto in the brief story Concert in O Minor for Harp and Nitroglycerin. The other romantic aspect is the intimacy that becomes poetic to confront longing, like Corto watching the sunrise. While irony is ever present throughout his stories, characters react to situation in thought balloons or in dialogues. The most evident example is, in original Italian, how the natives of African origin or islanders from the Pacific Ocean speak in Venetian dialect, making the situation slightly absurd. Also, the continuous back and forth between Rasputin and Corto in their adventures since their first appearance together. In his later years, Pratt becomes harder in his stories, always keeping the love of freedom and nature, but linking a price to it, meaning that his protagonists pay dearly this love for personal independence and lack of conformity. Like Chris Kenton, the protagonist of Wheeling, who in the third part of the story, written 33 years later than the first part, loses his house, his wife, and almost get condemned to death. Or the protagonist of El Gaucho, Tom Brown, a story just written by Pratt, who loses his grade in the military, the woman he's in love with, and all his friends, one of which he has to kill. This was a view of the red thread that connect all Pratt works. On a personal note, I would suggest you have a look at his water paint drawings, which explore some of the themes we talked about, like the immensity of nature and romantic filter. In the description of the video, you'll find a link to a couple of stories, so you can check it out yourself. If you enjoyed the video, click on like and subscribe. Onward to the next author!